Victoria Dale Harris says, I just saw an email from Matt Stone referring to the overly deified. I just saw an email from Matt Stone referring to the overly deified nutrient, vitamin A. He's referring to its probable role in asthma, but writes, I believe the etiology of the condition could be nearly identical to the etiology of many, if not most, inflammatory conditions. Also, a few bloggers are starting to spread the word, specifically Weston A. Price Foundation bloggers who are sick of really shitty results on a, now I have to mark this explicit in iTunes, really shitty results on a high A diet. Any thoughts about this and comments about vitamin A toxic levels? Pamela Schoenfeld responds, for what it's worth, as a practicing dietitian, I see a high percentage of individuals with signs of vitamin A deficiency, at least 25%, and I see good outcomes with daily supplementation between 3,000 and 10,000 IU. Okay. That comment did not go where I thought it was going to go, which is to the guy that Matt Stone is being influenced by right now about the vitamin A toxicity. So I'll save that for another time when someone brings that guy up. Okay, so look, I think that, you shouldn't deify any nutrient, right? There's any point of view that breaks the world down into good and bad molecules is a doomed to failure point of view, because molecules don't have virtues, okay? Like, everything is about context. And too much vitamin A, which cannot be defined outside of context, not just what are your needs are, not just what are your genetics, not just what is your turnover rate, not just what are your eye color, not just are you getting pregnant, but also the presence of other things in the diet. For example, vitamin D. For example, even vitamin E and K will affect the vitamin A requirement because they all regulate each other's breakdown. So look, some people have too much vitamin A. Some people take more vitamin A than they should. There's dozens of case reports of vitamin A toxicity, but there's no evidence that people at normal intakes who are not supplementing are getting inflammation from consuming dietary levels of vitamin A. And look at what Pam said. I see 25% of people who she sees, and that every practitioner does not see a random sample of the population. So like me, her, Chris Kresser, like anyone, pick them. Their sample is highly biased by the people who choose to come to them. But 25%, she sees signs of vitamin A deficiency that respond to vitamin A supplementation. That's a fairly large proportion. But look at the amounts she's using. 3,000, 10,000 IU is not a lot. The RDA is 3,000. If you're correcting deficiency, 10,000 is highly reasonable over a short period of time. And but look, if you have someone who has a very long history of taking vitamin A supplements at 30,000, 40,000, 50,000 IU over 3 years, then they might have all kinds of problems from that, because they're taking too much. And that's way more likely when they're not taking vitamin D, when they're not taking vitamin E, when they're not taking vitamin K. If you're taking this one vitamin at a very high dose, yes, it will cause toxicity. There's nothing remotely controversial about that. No reason to question it. And there are probably a lot of people in Weston A. Price who think that more of a good thing is better, and who are taking, I know for a fact that many people were taking 2 or 3 tablespoons of high vitamin cod liver oil for many years. And that was nuts. And it's nuts now. And they're getting too many fat soluble vitamins and too many polyunsaturated fatty acids from high levels of cod liver oil like that. But 3 to 10,000 IU, even long term, there's no evidence that that causes toxicity. But some people are going to be intolerant. I know anecdotes, I know stories of people who, for some reason, they take vitamin A at very low doses and it causes some hypersensitivity reaction. I don't know what causes it. So there will be stories of people who improve when they take the vitamin A out of their diet. It will happen. It makes sense. And on top of that, there are epidemic proportions of people with fatty liver. What happens when fatty liver gets bad? The cells that store vitamin A in the liver dump their vitamin A into the bloodstream so they can transform into cells that lay scar tissue down in the liver. So people with fatty liver, which is about 3/4 of people who are obese, right? So about 70 million Americans, maybe more now, have fatty liver disease. Some proportion of them are laying down scar tissue in their livers, and they are losing the ability to properly store and metabolize vitamin A. Could taking vitamin A out of the diet for them help? Probably, but it's a tough place to be in, because in those cases, those people are going to have cellular vitamin A deficiency. So it's like, do you save the liver or do you save everything else? Well, you might want to withdraw vitamin A in those cases, and you might want to fix the obesity and the fatty liver disease and then restore the vitamin A. That might be needed. But I have no problem saying that some people get too much vitamin A. Vitamin A can be toxic, but vitamin A, there are some people going around right now that are saying that vitamin A is a toxin and it's intrinsically toxic. And those people are truly, absolutely nuts. I'm not saying that Matt Stone, I don't know if he's saying that, but it's becoming very popular to say that. That is, that's flat earth level thinking that it's just intrinsically toxic and not a vitamin. Okay.